Can I have everybody stand up for a minute? Now I see my, do you guys see these slides? Where? You can read that from those? Are you all on the VIPAC or something? Oh, there they are. I can see them. Okay, fine. Thank you. I'm sitting here looking at these small things and I'm thinking, all right. This is something I did because when I took my first course in nutrition at the University of Michigan, I started realizing that no matter how hard we try, we couldn't all do it correctly. So with that in mind, those of you who have a relatively healthy diet, meaning you eat from the basic food groups, you have a relatively healthy diet, remain standing. Not bad, not bad. Okay, so all of you still standing have a relatively healthy diet, you eat from the basic food groups, and that's outstanding. This is California, that's why. You guys understand how. Okay, those of you who are still standing, those of you who have a minimum of 5 helpings of fruits and vegetables per day, I'd prefer 10, but if you do 5, remain standing. Remain standing for 5. And a helping, for those of you who don't know, is actually only half a cup. So a half a cup of broccoli, a half a cup of orange. Oh, I see a few people stand back up. That's a helping. So if you have 5 of those, you can remain standing. Okay, there's close to I was told there's about 900 people in here. So for round numbers, close to 1,000 people. There's not that many people still standing. Now, those of you who are still standing, those of you who have minimal to no stress in your life, remain standing. You're still standing. Oh, you're working. Oh, okay. I see a couple still people still standing. Very good. Wonderful. The point of this, and thank you very much, is that no matter how hard we try, no matter how hard we try to eat right, to get enough sleep, to do the things that we need to do, we can't do it all. And partly with that in mind, and even if you are doing it right, I do believe that there is enough compelling information that the nutrient density of our soil, the nutrient density of our foods is nowhere near like what it was 100 years ago. There's tons of evidence out there that tells us that that's the case. So with that in mind, I got my degree in nutrition, and I think there's a little bit of a background here. I'm just free associating a little bit here. But I am a surgeon. I work for a large health system, and I also direct their Center for Integrative Medicine and chair that committee on a national level for our American Academy of Otolaryngology as well. And I've been married, let's see now. Lynn never remembers. I always remember. 22 years, going on 23. And we have three children. And actually, I'm just thinking about this now. I got a phone call last night from Kevin, who's 15, my youngest, and told you the story. I should play the message for you. But it said he was playing his first 18s tournament. He doesn't have to play the 18s for tennis. He actually went and was a finalist in the state number 3 position last year and used Neuro all the way because we had just introduced it, by the way. So yesterday he calls me. He has to meet because he's moving up a bracket just because he wants to try to play up higher. He meets the number 2 seed in the first round. And he goes, "Yo, dog." This is my son talking. "Yo, dog." I'm listening to the message because I'll play it for anybody who wants to hear it afterwards. It's kind of funny. It's a little monotone 15-year-old kid's voice. "Yo, dog. Yeah, just finished playing a first round tennis. Met the number 2 single, and he's a pretty good player. Beat him 0-0. Said, had some neuro. It's great." And he hung up. But I will tell you, at States last year, it was really funny. Like, the coaches come up and said, "You know, my oldest son played, who was a good player." And he says, "You know, Jake was a great player." He says, "But," he says, "Kevin is, like, so smart. What's he doing?" He's just, and he wasn't always a smart player. I'm telling you, as placebo as you might call it, or as real as you might call it, the neuro has been amazing for him. So actually, I think I'm violating the rules on the package. It says don't give it to your kid if they're under like 16 or 18, but he likes it and he uses it. So anyways, my interests are up here. I'm not going to go into those because we can talk about it sometime when we're hanging out together. People always ask me why I got involved in this group. I've been designing and manufacturing supplements and giving them to professional athletes and giving them to my patients and my friends and the family and people that I love for a long time. And I was doing it on a one-to-one basis, giving one person at a time. And basically, Nick, Blake, and Ryan, I met them a few years back, and they said, hey, Seidman, you know, you're a nutritionist, you're an herbalist, you're a scientist, you're funded from the NIH, and you got professional athletes using this. Why not make these available to everybody? And I said, because I'm not comfortable selling anything. I said, you don't have to sell anything. All you have to do is talk the science. And I said, really? And they said, yeah, really. And I said, well, if that's all that I have to do, that's easy. That's fun for me. That's enjoyable. Because the science really makes a lot of sense. And I'm not going to bore you with it too much today. We had the practitioners workshop yesterday and the big group yesterday. Thank you all for coming. When you think about what's going on in the world, you have to realize any type of time or any time you have a solution, there has to be a problem. And that's really what the problem is look at our country. We are the richest country in the world. We spend the most, $2.2 trillion a year, which is 17% of our gross domestic product, $6,000 per person in this world, in this country we spend, yet we are ranked 37th. We are way behind just about every other major country in this world, and it's a very sad thought because we do spend a significant amount of money on our health care. And 62% of adults never participate in any leisure time or physical activity. About a fifth of us still smoke, 35% are considered obese, and 65% are considered overweight. So it's really time for a change when you stop and you think about it. When you think about the number one, two, and three killers, heart disease, cancer, and stroke, and I think the important part's not on the slide, but the important part is that heart disease, cancer, and stroke are largely preventable. And two-thirds to three-fourths of most medical disorders are preventable. Right out of the Center for Disease Control, we know doing this through lifestyle, through adjusting the things that we do, the things that we eat, the exercise we do, the amount of sleep that we get, and the nutrients that we take are all very important. Think about the fact that one person dies every 34 seconds from a heart attack. It's a very scary number. Does our diet help us? Well, half of our food dollars are eaten outside of the home. The average household eats fast food about 3 to 4 times per week. And when we're at home, we're still oftentimes eating fast food because we're bringing it from home. The slides are not advancing very well. Can somebody move this forward for me? Did this thing die? Thank you very much. Yeah, it had a heart attack. That's right. This is just showing you about diet and how it helps us or whether it doesn't help us. And when they surveyed this, they said, yeah, I eat fruits and vegetables. And about one-fifth answered that it was fried potatoes. That's French fries, McDonald's, or Burger King. So look at that number. It's actually quite interesting. And people always ask me, why supplement? Can't you get it from your food? For those of you who know me, you know that I make a bag of vegetables on Sunday evening. I make a bag that lasts me, you know, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and I eat them on Sunday. I take a day off. Everybody needs a day of rest from their vegetables, including me. My friends and colleagues say, hey, you know, you eat a healthy diet, you exercise every day, and, you know, can't you get it from your food? And the answer is to get enough vitamin E from food to reduce your risk of heart disease, you'd have to consume 9 tablespoons of olive oil, 75 slices of whole wheat bread, and 40 almonds or 200 peanuts each and every day. So the answer is you can, but it's not very practical. And then one of the other things that I would always tell people is that this is a study that came out, and it's interesting as to where we get our information. I'm not going to go into details of this today. I did this yesterday, as a matter of fact. This was a study that was published in the Journal of the American Medical Association, and the title of the article is Mortality in Randomized Trials of Antioxidant Supplements for Primary and Secondary Prevention. And what the study showed was not what the newspapers printed. The newspapers printed that vitamins increase mortality. So it was in Yahoo, it was in MSN, it was in CNBC, it was in the Washington Post, it was in the Wall Street Journal. And it's interesting because this is how most of us get our information. This is how most doctors surprisingly get their information. The patient brings it to them, hey doctor, did you see this article? You know that, you know, doing bypass surgery doesn't save patients and, you know, vitamins kill you. And it was a very interesting story, and that's not what it said. And there was a huge critique of this, and just basically the paper was lambasted. And what they found is that there were major flaws in how they did their reporting. And of a possible 815 studies that were looked at, of a possible 815 studies, 68 were selected. So they eliminated 91% of them. The reason they eliminated 91% of them is because they showed zero mortality. So they showed no deaths. So this is a serious selection bias, almost on the border of fraudulent, if you will. These people were actually lambasted afterwards. And then the studies that came out and the comments that came out This was Meyer Stanford, who said, the study does not advance our understanding and easily leads to misinterpretation of the data. And then the director of the endowed chair at the Linus Pauling Institute said, this is flawed analysis. The totality of the evidence indicates that antioxidants from food or supplements have many health benefits, reduces risk from heart disease, from cancer, from eye disease, neurodegenerative diseases, which means like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease, and that they're a key to enhance immune system and resistance to infection. So the issue is, what comes out in the papers is what they tell us, and it's not really what the paper had said. And really, it just goes on and on that people comment on the dangers of interpreting this study in the way that they had done it. So it was a very bad study, but what came out is what we all saw in the Washington Post. I actually critically reviewed it, and there's about 10 more slides, which I will spare you from today, but I went through them yesterday, and we just sort of picked at it, because that's really what I do for our health system. That's what I do for Visalus, is we look at the studies that are out there, we analyze whether they make sense, whether they're done correctly, and if things are interesting and helpful, we change the VIPAC. That's the other thing, is the VIPAC is not stagnant. When new data and new evidence comes out, we change, we add, we subtract, and we manipulate. We bring on new products. It's a very exciting time. It's a very exciting company. They give us lots of carte blanche to make changes, which is just a wonderful thing. So when you look at Visalus, you know, why Visalus products? Well, patented. We have a patent-pending Neuro Smart Energy drink. It's very difficult to get patents. I know there's a couple of you out there that have patents. I talked to a few of you. We all know that it takes 3 to 10 years to get a patent if you're lucky, and hundreds of thousands of dollars. The minerals inside the vitamins are basically chelated, which means that they are tagged to an amino acid. Your body does not absorb minerals very well, but it absorbs amino acids very well. So it brings in the amino acid, and then basically you bring in the mineral as well. We're made in an FDA-inspected laboratory, which is basically means that everything that comes in gets tested, gets analyzed, and gets sent out on a third-party laboratory to verify that what we say is inside there is inside there. So, you know, I was asked to tell you why be a distributor, and I'm probably not the world's best person to tell you to why be a distributor. And so my thoughts are, you know, I am able to, again, impart the ability to discuss the nutrients and the vitamins to one person at a time. With people like you going out there, it just spreads the message. So to me, you can be that beacon. You can disseminate the word about the benefits of lifestyle and appropriate supplementation. You know, you can share the reasons that really can't be told on a package label or in a store shelf. And it really makes a difference in your life. We can't tell you how many people come up to me each and every day and say, it has lowered my cholesterol, it has done this, it has done that. And as exciting as that is for me, they are still anecdotes in the scientific world, but I'm very excited that people have noted dramatic changes in their lives. So it gives you the opportunity to help somebody else, which is very exciting. The future, we talked about it briefly, new products, new categories of health. We have many things on the works, things like PMS formulas, menopause formula, anti-cholesterol formulas. I can't tell you when they're going to be there. They're in testing phases. We've tested them on actually thousands of people now and had very promising and exciting results. We really won't rule things out to you until we are sure that they are A, effective, B, safe, and that's what we're working on at the time. So they're also working with new ways for you to help spread the cause of living healthier lives and helping others achieve life, health, and prosperity, which is part of the message of Visalus Sciences. So we have developed the VIPAC. The VIPAC is, as you see here, I've had the opportunity, I've been blessed with the opportunity to be asked over the years, what should we be taking? And in this picture here, I don't know if this laser, the laser does work. This is Florine Mark, who started Weight Watchers. This is Andrew Weil, and this is me. Again, I have a shiny forehead today. It's very hot up here, and I got a shiny forehead over here, as you can see as well. It was hot in the picture, too. So I apologize for that. But you can notice that my list is very long, and everything in this list is really what the VIPAC is made of. And so what I tell people is the Hopkins newsletter comes out and says, smart people take a good multiple vitamin in A, C, and E. And then I say, that's good, but really smart people take that plus extra zinc and selenium and copper and manganese, because those things are necessary to make your superoxide dismutase, your glutathione peroxidase, and your catalase enzymes work that detoxify us from oxidation and from free radicals. And then I say, really, really smart people.